I like to look beneath the surface of things. I like to read between the lines. The furious opposition to Donald Trump has nothing to do with Russians or opportunistic porn stars or what he may have said off camera to some gossip show host. The fear and loathing that this man engenders on the left has to do with some deeper psychological triggers. I've thought of five of them. Here they are. Number five, Trump is unpretentious. The main theory of progressives is that humans can be perfected if we would just do as they say. Therefore, they are always performing the role of enlightened New Age human. Donald Trump, on the other hand, has completely rejected the pretension you see everywhere among progressives. Progressives pretend not to be competitive. They pretend not to be greedy and jealous and full of themselves. Trump is no worse than anybody else. He just refuses to pretend that he's any better. Of course, he constantly brags about being better, but this just makes him look worse, which proves that he doesn't care about looking like he's any better. Blue-collar people seem to get this, but it really gets under the skins of the pretentious left. Number four, Trump is not an intellectual. This guy is plenty smart, but if he ever cared about being an intellectual, that was a long time ago. The intellectuals would have you believe that they are in a line of great thinkers going back to the Greeks. When they tell you what they studied in grad school, they always tell you who they studied under and who that person studied under, until they trace their intellectual lineage back to a famous scholar. This is a type of academic hero worship. It's also a way of establishing authority. The progressive movement is based on the theories of important thinkers. And given the fact that real life continues to disprove all of these theories, it's crucial that they keep their intellectual pedigrees front and center, dazzling the next generation with big words and constant references to the ideas of the great thinkers. In this way, an intellectual can be seen as brilliant without ever offering a single original idea, and without ever building a single common sense argument. Number three, Trump is the ultimate celebrity. Leftism is a collectivist philosophy. They insist on unity of thought. Makes sense. You can't have collective action without collective opinion. In the interest of this, they have taken over four key segments of society: academia, the arts and show business, mainstream media, and liberal politics. And in each of these segments, there are celebrities who popularize the ideas that the collective is then required to affirm. If you can't get everybody into the colleges, you need famous people to make the case. For 40 years, Trump used liberal mainstream media to become an international celebrity. He then used liberal politicians to get an inside view of their game. Finally, he used show business to present himself as a firm, no-nonsense decision maker. Then he crashed the grid and stole the White House. Now, when progressives turn to the hive mind for instructions, all they hear is Trump, Trump, Trump. They hate him so much that they can't think of anything else. In a real sense, Trump has reduced every one of their celebrity thought directors into a nonstop publicity machine for, well, Donald Trump. And he did it from the inside. Trump didn't just dismantle Hillary Clinton's candidacy and leave the whole party in tatters. He knows Hillary. He knows Bill. He personally had access to every political superstar that your average progressive longs to hang out with. Trump used them, tossed them aside, and defected to the GOP. That really stings. Number two, he is the exact mirror opposite of Barack Obama. Obama represents two things in the world. Of course, he represents the first black president. After several tries, the left finally managed to get a black person into the White House. That was job one for the aging activist bucket list. But Obama also represents something just as sacred to these graying ex-radicals. He is the very embodiment of the cool college professor. You see, back in the day, when they were finally free from the jocks and cheerleaders who ran their high school, when they had been admitted into the storied halls of academe, each of them had a key experience. It went something like this. Well, that was a very interesting perspective. What's your name again? Please, elaborate. Tell us more. The validation that they had always sought came from the cool college professor. That professor was worldly and hip with an offhand grasp of culture and that whip-smart sense of humor that Jon Stewart later turned into a gold mine. Obama is that guy. He has so internalized the cool professor that the act works with every liberal who ever studied the humanities while battling youthful insecurity. Trump is the exact opposite in every way. Think about it. He's crude where Obama is smooth. His humor is like a chainsaw next to Obama's scalpel. He didn't go to college to learn the etiquette of the intellectuals. He went to college to get richer than he already was. In a very real sense, progressives see him with his gorgeous wife, and in their emotional minds, they're right back on the high school quad being blown off by the popular quarterback and his flawless cheerleader girlfriend. They look at the Trumps and see people who skipped classes and breezed through life, looking down their noses at the nerdy kids doing all the work. That's the image they have of Trump and Melania. And baby, that one hurts. This brings us to number one, the number one thing that fills them with dread. Trump is fearless. When people ask me why the left is so afraid of conservatives, I tell them this. They aren't afraid of conservatives. They're afraid of each other. That's the truth of it. The left has always been a reaction to what they perceived as the keepers of the status quo. In my video, Why Are They Always Wrong?, I break it down. Suffice it to say that they live in an unresolved adolescent rebellion against mom and dad. Fine. But mom and dad were right about most things, which means that the left is wrong about most things. Because leftist policies continually fail, it's become crucial to silence dissent. Left-wing brains are in lockdown. Political correctness is the straitjacket strapped over their minds. It prevents them from really thinking deeply about any of the issues put forth by the change junkies running the show. Why would they want to think these issues through? They know they won't be allowed to disagree. If they look at an issue and don't sign on to what their leaders say, they stand to lose their social group, their jobs, even their families. Open-minded inquiry into a new idea is fraught with danger for a person under the thumb of the progressives. Critical thought becomes untenable. They don't really believe that there are suddenly a dozen genders. They don't really believe that the most pressing issue for Black Americans is racism. They don't really believe that raising children is less important than shuffling papers in a cubicle downtown. But they cannot speak for fear of losing membership in the only cool kids group that ever accepted them. But Trump can, and Trump does. And the man's willingness to trash PC conventions is spreading like wildfire. Online, there is a growing number of men and women with world-class intellects and no time for political correctness. They sell out speaking engagements, and their videos get millions of views. Progressives are faced with the real possibility that Donald Trump, this boorish cad, may well be the wrecking ball that destroys the left-wing mind prison. And that really scares them. So those are my top five Trump triggers. Let me know what you think. Thanks for watching. If you like this video, subscribe to our channel, and then click the little bell to get notifications.